It is the 17th of January 2019 and I'm on my way to college. I think it's 9 and I'm slightly late, and this is not something I'm not always late. I keep saying it again and again. But anyway, so today is basically the first day of Econvista, which is our economics fest, annual department fest, and I'm really excited. It's gonna be a really chill and it's on the knees. There's a lot of activity and action happening. There's a panel discussion. There is a really interesting keynote speaker coming in, and different competitions that we're all organizing together. And they're all like really interesting and dynamic. So we're all looking forward to actually giving everyone an awesome time at Econvista. Guys, this is we're in a tricky situation. My shawl is there and we can't go, and like this is law. And we have our event really soon. And this is an issue. Nikita, what do we do?
We pick them out.
How? There's like no option.
Hey, hi.
We're all event heads and they're the buds. We're the buds. This is Nikita.
Hi.
Devangi, who's obsessed at looking at her pictures. This is me, Dhwani. And our event is gonna start right now. It's like 10.
12:30 it starts.
And our event's gonna start at 12:30, but we are getting a photo shoot because getting into these sarees was a pain in the morning. So we're heading to our event. It's in the new conference hall. And right now we just had a very interesting keynote speech. And that was fun, actually. And we just got like a photo session because that's what you do when you wear a sari. And yep, our event is gonna start in, it's like what, 10:40. And our event starts at 12:30, so we're going to meet our volunteers and just talk to them and just set everything up. So very excited for that, and day one of Econvista has kicked in.
Hello, auntie.
Hi.
My favorite, tomato rice and vada pav. Thank you, auntie.
So this is my meal from the South Indian auntie, and I love the South Indian auntie, and this is what's happening. Lemon rice and whatever, because we have to stop ourselves before we even get some energy.
Logistics plus hospitality.
Do you like doing that?
To be honest.
Do you like us?
Yes, I do. I guess so.
We're nice. Yeah. Like, I'm bullying the kids into saying good stuff about us. Yeah, look at this. Meena, yeah, I have a lot of integrity, honesty, and character. That's what dreams are made of. Me.
Congratulations to all teams for qualifying to round two from a large cohort of applicants that were really interesting and very dynamic.
So this is our case study, and this is what they have to solve, and these are the updates. Yep, so they're all just working really hard, trying to do all of this. It's fun. Guys, so not much time is left. The event is about to get over and we're about to take it. And when I say the event's about to get over, the time to prepare their solutions is about to get over, and they're going to submit their answers finally. And we will be checking them. They'll be speaking in front of the judges. That's about to happen. Excited to see how the teams have analyzed the game.
These applies which they are lacking right now. The political solution is that we feel that violence is not a correct solution, so what we can do is...
Sorry, round two is over and it was pretty cool. Some teams were really good actually, some were okay, of course, like that's the way it is. We had a gala time and now we're gonna get some food because we're exhausted and it's around 1:30-ish. Devangi is wearing dark blue, Nikita is wearing light blue, I'm wearing dark blue. It's pretty cool. We didn't even coordinate, we're just really coordinated. Coordinator/event head. Version of celebration, zero alcohol, nah, it's life.
And I love potatoes.
And yeah. And
I'm glad that the event was a success, and now we're waiting for the third round tomorrow.
Yes. Sorry, he's in Starbucks. Hey, Nikita.
Hi.
Cheers. What are we doing?
We're having coffee after a very long day.
Yes.
And successful event.
But the day is not over, we're still doing some work,
yes,
on this.
We're working in Starbucks and Sardis, we're making coffee.
Yes, and we're also kind of, you know, we're gonna be in time to college at 5:15 for our organizing committee picture.
Yes, that.
basically, cheers to coffee. I'm trying this new drink. It's called hazelnut dark cocoa praline something. I don't know. And it tastes quite nice. And I'm not being paid for this at all. I'm just doing this because I like it. It's a nice drink. Remember that, guys.
Today is the 18th of January 2019 and I'm on my way to college for the panel discussion, and I'm pretty excited for it. Some really awesome speakers are coming. So there's John Jesse coming in, there is the assistant director of what is it? It's policy and training South Asia at J-PAL coming in. There are some public policy specialists coming in. There are various people coming in for the panel discussion, and I'm very excited for it. I really want my brain juices flowing. And then we have the round two or round three of EcoPrayog, which is the final round. So yesterday, five teams qualified, and now they'll be participating to win. And it's just really nice to see our event be a success. And it'll be today. Today's gonna be a super long day.
They're quite intuitive moral statements. Yes, we need full universal access to energy. We need quality education for everyone. We need to eliminate extreme poverty. Very intuitive questions. Then why is it that we need paradigms like the SDGs?
It is a limited form of global cooperation because it is basically sponsored by governments and takes place within the framework that is acceptable to the governments. For example, I was disappointed to see that under the goal of peace and justice, there was no mention of nuclear disarmament, presumably because...
Hi guys! So we just attended the panel discussion and it was super interesting. Very, very enriching, in fact. The moderator was so good and so were the other panel discussions, panelists. We had a really interesting conversation about the Sustainable Development Goals, what are the problems, how do you actually navigate through that, and one is, what's the role of the state, what's the role of the market, at the ground level, how do you make those changes, and how do you actually encapsulate them into really becoming something that's a way of life. So that was something pretty fascinating.
Given unique solutions to Alanzia's debilitating crises of hyperinflation, extremism, and post-war destruction. Today, a rather pressured and exciting event has been designed for you. So be prepared to use your innovative ideas and your creativity to come up with out-of-the-box solutions.
So we took a very important resource, which was that we can leave this room and talk to the people out there on what exactly is the problem that they are facing. So we went to a few economic setups that we already know of, the Nescafe, the canteen, the bookstores. We talked to the Nescafe guy. He said that they earn 26,000 a day. He was a bit... was not ready to give out the figure easily, so we estimate it is the lower half, about 20,000 a day. And I asked him specifically, are you making profit? He said yes.
We are rich, very rich. People are seeing us.
Yeah. Hey guys, so the second round of EcoPrayog is going on and the event is pretty cool. The teams are really working under the pressure situation that they have. So they basically have been given certain resources and a fixed income, and they have to, with that fixed income, gather those resources, and they've been given an economics topic and make a presentation of sort on that topic. It could be a PPT, it could be a skit, it could be a verbal presentation, etc. or a video, and so that's what they're working on. And there are loads of elements, so we're just waiting for them to come back after that stipulated time. It's like killing time right now, but yeah. Guys, now it's over and now we're just heading out because there's a concert, for Prateek Kuhad concert. This is Shifra. Hey.
Hey.
Nikita ja rahi hai ghar.
Hi.
And so we're just heading out there and yeah, so we're really excited.
Show me how you do. Pass me the ball, got the milk in this room.